Good morning from Arizona. This is our first full day in Arizona. I never mentioned I was going to Arizona, I think. Well, I think I mentioned briefly in another video, but we got here yesterday. Today's our first full day, and currently we are on Camelback Mountain, which is a place people come to hike. And I don't know, we've been here maybe like 10 minutes now or so, and we've just been walking up a bunch of rock stairs lately, and I don't see anyone else here. But like my sister said, it's a Thursday. Oh! So, I mean, obviously it's a work day while we are on vacation. So I don't know, there could be people at the top of the mountain. But anyway, I don't know if we're gonna go all the way to the top, because apparently it's extremely difficult. As you can tell, I'm like losing my breath. We got a straggler down there. So yeah, I don't know if we're gonna make it to the top, but so far it's been easy going, except now it feels like it's a little bit more difficult. You can see the trail for a bit. Initial thoughts on Arizona, what's it called? Atmosphere, whatever. It's cool. I mean, it's very dry, like, because it's the desert, as they say. I mean, I don't really know, but it's nice. It's different from back home on the East Coast. And yeah, so you can see there's a lot of rocky areas. So I will let you go, because it's hard to vlog and concentrate at the same time, and I don't want to fall. So I will check off on you later. Here's an overview of the city.
This is where we are.
This is like literally like 5 minutes since I last checked in, but we just had to stop and take a little bit of a break and catch our breath. But as you can see, it's like overcast today. It's not sunny. It's not hot, which is good. If I didn't mention, it's a little chilly. So it's nice weather, because then at least you're not really like sweating too much. Okay, update. It's starting to drizzle a little bit more than it was a couple minutes ago.
Oh, yeah.
So we only made it to marker 20. You can see. Oh shit, honey. My god, you're gonna fall.
I'm going back down.
I don't know if it's in frame, but marker 20. We only made it to there. Then someone who was coming down the mountain told us that. He probably knew that we were noobs, but anyway. Like, he told us that, oh, we should be careful because, like, it starts to get slippery when it's raining, which is obvious. I mean, it's just a bunch of dirt and rocks. So, I mean, we have a long way back to go down, because I think we pretty much made it like just about halfway, maybe, in my terms. But we're gonna start our descent back down the mountain. And it was fun while it lasted. Oh my god. I'm recording you, by the way.
I thought you were.
Oh no, it's like raining. Shit. Oh my god, we almost fell. It's like raining now. Not like, it's not like raining like heavily, but it's like rain. What? So, unfortunately we couldn't make it up the mountain, but hopefully when we come back to Arizona again, definitely not in the summer though, when it's fucking 100 plus degrees. But definitely when it's cool, we can come back and maybe make it to the top. We just about made it to the end, the beginning, the end, whatever. So we made it. Now I'm gonna show you the hardest part of getting up here.
Log update.
We're walking down the hill that we walked out from, from where we parked the car. And look, vlogging.
You're just vlogging for me. This is the hardest part of the whole trail, isn't it?
What?
Walking back to the car.
No.
It's a joke.
Oh.
Cause it literally takes like maybe like 5-10 minutes to get to the start of the trail. Cause you park in the street. Cause there's no parking. Like,
it's residential.
Yeah, it's a residential street where the trail starts. So you're not allowed to park here. So you have to park on the kind of like the main road, I guess, because this guess would technically be kind of like a side street. So it takes a bit of walking to get there. So I feel like there's a big echo. I feel like the ultimate test if you can actually get up Camelback Mountain is that if you can walk up to the start of the trail from where you parked your car, then you can probably make it somewhat. But yeah, overall, it was really fun to do because it's not something we do at home really. Especially where we live, it's not like an area like that. We've been hiking before, but it's in an area, it's kind of like up in the mountains. Kind of like a half hour, 40 minutes from our house. So that's the only hiking that we've done previously, but it's really fun to do different, definitely different exercise and just like going to the gym. Like you get to explore and like be outside instead of indoors and soak in the wilderness or whatever. I mean, it's not really wilderness, but you know what I mean. Morning. Well, it's almost afternoon. It's almost noon here in Arizona. Right now, we are just kind of killing time before we have a show to go to tonight. And one of the main things that we're doing around here is like thrifting, because if anyone knows who the fashion citizen is on YouTube, I've been watching them for...
since the beginning.
Can you, like, this is my vlog. Anyway, the fashion citizen on YouTube, they're twin sisters from Arizona. And they specialize in like thrifting and, well, vlogging, thrifting. We've been watching them since their DIY videos and thrift hauls and stuff back in the day, probably like 2011, 2010 era. And we always wanted to come to Arizona for thrifting because they make thrifting look so awesome, but we never had an excuse to come to Arizona until now. So it's really cool that we're actually here. And right now we are at Savers, which is a thrift store we don't have back at home. I see a lot of Savers hauls on YouTube. I don't watch them, but I mean, I know a lot of people go to Savers and it seems like a really awesome thrift store. Back home we only have like Goodwill, Salvation Army, and like local thrift shops. So I mean, whatever. I mean, I just want to see what they have here. I don't really expect to buy anything, nor should I buy anything, because we don't have room in our luggage for anything. But I don't know, it's nice to experience thrifting in a different area than back home. So we're gonna go. It's also raining outside. Here is the storefront and you can see the rain. Yep. So we're gonna go.
It's raining.
Yes, it's raining.
So it's almost a little bit, it's like 3:40 and we got ready for the show tonight and
running later than I wanted to, but it's okay. It's my fault because I always keep getting lost while I'm driving because, I don't know, I find the road just the whole point of driving is like just really confusing and annoying. I don't know why. Like, I act like I'm driving in a different country, but so I don't know. I'm just frustrated every time I get into the car and having to drive because, like, it takes us like, it could take us like, the GPS says it's like 20 minutes to the destination. It'll take me like an hour to get there. Not really, but it feels like that because, I don't know. I'm a very cautious driver and it's annoying. And right now it's raining, which is annoying because we forgot to bring an umbrella with us. And I meant to go buy an umbrella, but I forgot. It's too late. We don't have time to get an umbrella. And then you might be able to hear that it's raining even harder now. You can see the rain. It's fucking ugly outside. And you see it on my windshield. Yeah, so not a good day in Arizona. But that's okay. Hopefully we have a better night. It's Saturday, the 21st, the day we've been waiting for like 5 months or so. Today is 8123 Fest, which is festival celebrating the Maine's 10-year anniversary as a band. Yeah, so we're just in the car. It's about 10 o'clock in the morning, and we're gonna go grab something to eat before we go head over to the venue. Yeah, and I'm just gonna do my hair.
The lighting is technically bad.
I don't care.
Just saying.
This isn't like, I don't care what you think. There's, as long as you can see my face, doesn't matter.
We got food from Delight, or used to be called Delish. Also a recommendation we got from watching The Fashion Citizen.
It's so good. I'm eating like a veggie burrito.
I'm eating like, it's called a California Club sandwich.
It's like the best thing I've eaten in a while. I don't know.
I'm so good. That's an honest reaction because I never see her do that.
It's so good. I have no other words to say, but it's so good.
the bottom of our hearts, thank you so, so, so much.
What to do? Behind the picture taking.
My sound. Let's go. You don't. I can't even see my food. This is my food. Quesadillas. What did you get?
Victoria can.
What?
Biscuits. Biscuits and with mushroom gravy.
And
all this food is vegan and vegetarian.
This is fries with chili and guacamole. Vlogging at the same time as me. Anyway, today is Monday. I don't know what day it is, but we are at the Desert Botanical Gardens, Phoenix. Today is kind of like a touristy day for us because first day we don't have anything like to do with the purpose of why we're here. So we're about to go in and see naturist things, right?
What?
Naturist stuff. Like, you don't even have to pay to go in. All you have to do is see this stuff. There's a field trip going on over there, I'm assuming. Look how beautiful this place is. Just a lot of desert. It's very pretty, and then you see that mountain in the background, I don't know what it is.
What's wrong with that?
Me taking selfies in front of things. We always see that. Look, honey, look at that. It looks like a...
Oh. Oh.
Quintessential desert shot. Look at this background. Wonderful, amazing, beautiful. All the synonyms of such a word. Creeping up on her over there. Let's go creep on her. I wonder if she's doing the same thing I'm doing. Are you? Are you? These cactuses over here, cacti, are called old man cactus. I wonder why. We're trying to choose.
You want a dark one or
these light? Rocks. No, I don't want a dark one. I think like an in-between color. Maybe like a color like this, but I don't know if I like that one.
I didn't really figure that out myself. Wait, this one?
That one's not too bad.
Yeah.
This one's coming home with us.
Who wants to come home with us? This one does.
We're currently at a hole, hole in the rock. It's a local attraction nearby the gardens that we were just at, and we're going up
these kind of rock stairs. I don't know if we're gonna actually make it to the hole in the rock, because we saw people like kind of rock climbing on the side from the front. So I don't know where we're gonna go to. I'm already out of breath. So we'll see where we get to. Got the view over there. Good morning. It is January 24th. That's Tuesday. We're going home today, but we're gonna do a few last minute. We're only going to one more place. One last minute sightseeing place, and then we will be heading to the airport, and then we will be traveling for most of the day. Not most of the day, but just like it'll feel like that. Pretty sad about leaving. I don't know, not like, I guess it's just like, oh, that post-concert depression sort of thing. And just like, you know, we came here for the first time. My hair, what is my hair doing over here? I have to redo my hair, but anyway. First time coming to Arizona, and it was cool. Wish I could have saw more things, but when you come back, probably go to more areas in Arizona than just like the Grand Canyon and stuff like that. So, oh, can you stop backseat vlogging for me? Okay, so we are currently at a place called South Mountain / Dobbins Lookout, which is in Phoenix, and it overlooks all the city. And we just drove like probably like 20 minutes up to the top of it. I mean, you could hike here, but obviously we don't have time for that or energy for that. But you can drive all the way up to the top, and then you can see everything. That's there. I don't know if you can see it, but later on I'll go over there. But it's so beautiful. You can see just everything. Look at the detail on the mountains here. See it.